One. So this is a question that was asked by a student, and they wanted to just get some more information about how to simplify radical expressions, specifically this one that I did in the notes on the day that we, first learned this, right? So anyway, I'm going to show you two ways to do this. One is just a more thorough explanation of what we did in the notes, and then the second one will be a different way of thinking about it too, because with these radical expressions, right, with the cube roots, the square roots, all that kind of stuff, right? We have an equivalent way to write those using rational exponents, right? And so that creates kind of two different paths to solve any of these problems you ever kind of come across. All right, so let's go and we'll start with the rational exponents first, and then I'll show you how to solve it using the radicals too. I'll move that over some. Okay, so first of all, with the rational exponents, okay, we need to rewrite all of these radical symbols here as rational powers, exponents. So I'll leave the x, right? This cube root becomes 2y to the 1/3 power, and then the cube root of 4x squared y squared becomes 4x squared y squared to the 1/3 power, okay? Now, when you have a product inside, a product of two things, right, or three things or whatever, a product of, terms here, product of numbers and variables that are being raised to an exponent, okay, you can distribute that exponent to both terms. In other words, this is like that, right? This is 2 to the 1, this is y to the 1, so we just multiply the 1/3 to both of those 1s. Okay, and then likewise here as well, we're going to distribute this 1/3 to the 4, so it becomes 4 to the 1/3. We'll distribute the 1/3 times the x squared, and since that's a power to a power, we're going to get x to the 2/3. And then the 1/3 times the y squared to the 1/3, okay, distribute that. Again, we multiply the powers y to the 2/3, like that. Okay, now we have this one big product here. I mean, you could put parentheses here and parentheses here, but there's nothing more to do with those parentheses, so we can kind of drop them. It's all just one big product. So a property of multiplication, I should say, right, is that, 2 times 3 is the same as 3 times 2. So in other words, you can change the order of multiplication around, and it'll still end up with the same result, as long as it's all one big product like this. So I'm going to rewrite everything in order of numbers, then x's, then y's, right? So right now I have 2 to the 1/3. Times 4 to the 1/3, okay, and then x to the 2/3, okay, again, just grouping those two things together, and then I'll group these two y's, so y to the 1/3 times y to the 2/3. So now I simplify from here. I'll come back to the numbers in just a second. I'm going to focus on the variables first. Okay, so let's take care of these x's. Remember, this is just x to the 1, because there's no, power written there. We assume it's a 1. And so now we're multiplying, right? When you multiply, what do you do with your exponents? You add them, okay? But now we're going to do, so I'll just write them like this. Okay, so it becomes x to the 1 plus 2/3 power. Likewise here at the y's, right, we're multiplying them, so we're going to add their exponents. So it's going to be y to the 1/3 plus 2/3 power. Excuse me. And then this last one, well, it's a little bit trickier here because they don't have the same base, right? 2 is not the same base as 4. We could, we have a couple options here. We could rewrite 4 as 2 squared and go about it that way. Or we could also just see that they both have the same exponent, right? They both have the exponent of 1/3. And so since they both have the same exponent of 1/3, we can kind of recollect them together. And kind of as a product of the bases, and then just raise it to the 1/3 power like that. So we kind of recollect the 2 and the 4 there underneath that 1/3 power, which allows us to make it 8/3, or 8 to the 1/3, I should say. Okay? So it's your choice. Again, I could have made this 4 a 2 squared to the 1/3, which would then make it to 2 to the 2/3, because again, power to a power here. You multiply the powers to get your simplified answer. And it'd be 2 to the 2/3 times 2 to the 1/3, which again, we would add the exponents and we get 2 to the 3/3, which is the same thing as, well, yeah, which is the same thing as 2. And this will simplify to just 2 as well. Okay, yeah. 2 to the 2/3 times 2 to the 1/3 will become 2 to the 3/3, which is just 2 to the 1. And this will simplify to 1, too. Okay? Anyway, let's finish adding these together. So we got to add these two fractions, right? We need common denominators. So we'll change this 1 to a 3 over 3. And so 3 thirds plus 2 thirds gives us 5 thirds. Like so. And then 1 third plus 2 thirds is 3 thirds, which is just y to the 1, or just y, if you like. And then there's our answer. Oops, sorry, that's not our answer. 2 x to the 5 thirds y. So here's a sufficient answer right here. Now, let me know if you have any further questions on that one. If you want to keep watching, I'm going to also then talk about how to simplify this using radicals. So leaving it in the kind of radical form that we see right here. Okay, so in this case, we're going to take advantage of the fact that both have the same radical, right? They're both cube roots. And since they're both products and cube roots, okay, right? If this was like a plus sign in there, we wouldn't be able to do this. But since it's a product and it's cube roots, we can combine the cube root of those products together, okay? So the cube root of a product is equal to the product of the cube roots. You know, in general, if you have something like this, that's going to equal this. And vice versa, right? So right now we have this, we have two separate things, right? And we're going to combine them together to make one separate thing, or one united thing. So it'll look something like this. And now we can just combine all this junk here on the inside of the cube root. So let's see here, we'll get 8 x squared y to the third, okay? And now to simplify this, we're going to break up the cube root over these three things right here. Okay, so we'll say x cube root of 8, cube root of x squared, cube root of y cubed. Okay, now we can cube root 8, no problem, it's 2, so we'll get a 2x. Cube root of x squared, can't really do anything with that, right? Cube root x squared, there's not enough x squareds in there to make a cube root, so we're kind of done with that, okay? So for example, if this was like the cube root of x to the fifth, we could break that x to the fifth up and make it x cubed times x squared, which would allow us to then cube root that x cubed, but leave the x squared underneath. As an example, that would become just x there, and then we'd have times a cube root of x squared, okay? But we don't have enough x's to make a cube root here, so we're gonna have to leave it. Okay, and then cube root of y cubed, well, that's just going to be y, right? Y is a perfect cube. We're going to cube root it, so it just becomes y. And that's our final answer here. Now, you might look at this and say, Mr. Witt, this does not look like that. Well, not exactly like it, right? I see the 2. I see the y. But here we have an x and a cube root of x squared. And here we just have x to the 5 thirds. What the heck? Well, I could break this x to the 5 thirds up, remember, and say that's 2 x to the 3 thirds y, and then x to the 2 thirds, right? The 2 thirds and 3 thirds would combine back together to give you a 5 thirds here, would it not, right? And so there's your 2 x y that you see right here, right? And then there's your cube root of x squared that you see right here. Okay, so they are the same. And it's really just a matter of like what you're trying to do that makes you decide how you want to rewrite those. Okay, you know, there's different applications for both of these, so it's really up to you to make that decision sometimes about how you want to simplify it, or sometimes the directions will guide you to. Hope that helps. Let me know if you have any further questions. Thanks for sticking with me here, and yeah, I can do more if you need to. So have a good day. Bye.